replacement grips were drawn in Fusion 360. You do need to take the coupler apart to press these together. This is double-sided. It can go on in either direction. This one wants to face to the outside here on the hose side. So this one presses on here like that. This one you have to pay attention to where this little lip is. And that lip is the part that pushes that spring down. And it needs to be to this curved end. So that'll get pressed on there like that. And then the one for the hose attachment, that needs to go on here in this direction. These have been assembled. This piece goes on here. There is a little variation in the knurling that's on these brass pieces. These went on very easily. Some of the other ones, it's a very tight press fit. You can print one of these things until this gets to be about that thick, and then stop the print, take it off, and try it on one of these and see how it's doing. If it's too tight, you can make it 101% on Cura and try that. If it's too loose, you can go to 99%. But for the ones that I have, these fit quite well. And the files for these will be on Thingiverse under my name. After digging further in my box of fittings, I found out I actually had two different types of hose end fittings. The ones that have this type of knurl, the grip that goes on there is called hose end grip. But then I found that I had some of these that are, they have a double row of knurling on it. And I believe that this is the one that originally had the rubber piece that was either pressed or molded on there. And those lasted no time at all. They fell off pretty quick. So I have redrawn the grip for this one. In the Thingiverse files, I will list this as large hose end grip. And it just has a larger hole in it. And this is a small rack and pinion press that I'm going to be using. On some of these, where the knurling was a little bit tight on the first fittings I printed some of these at 101%. And you got to make sure that this lip is facing upwards towards this curved end. And in there, and I've got a little piece of brass that just happens to fit in there. Makes life a little easier. Go around and just nudge it in a little bit further. And you can do the same thing in the bench vise. This piece can go either way. It's the same both ways. And we put this on here. And just start nudging it in there. And you don't want to press on this too hard because you don't want to deform where that split ring goes back in there. So those two will go back together like that. When you put one of these together, you slide this back and this will not go in. That means that these balls are not able to retract back here. And what's causing that, you print this at 101% in the X, Y, and Z axis, you're also increasing this thickness. And this can come up here enough to prevent that slide part from moving enough to allow these balls to fully retract. So take it apart again. Take one of these, screw it in there. And this section here is going down into that slot. Put that over there. And then just bump that gently. That will move this piece in that direction. When you reassemble it, it'll go together like it's supposed to. So if you're going to print this at 101%, only do it in the X and Y axis. You take one of the hose end adapters that's got the single row of knurling. Put this on here and just press it in there. Go a little further. And I'll come along here and just using the backing plate for the press to flush that out. So now that plastic and the brass is flush. So when these pieces get pressed on there, there's no room for it. And it has to be flush on this side. Doing one of the hose end adapters, it has this double row of knurling. Using the large hose end grip. Until the brass is again flush with the plastic. With everything reassembled, those go in there. When you get through installing these, I made this wide enough to be a comfortable grip when you're trying to tighten this on a hose. And there is a bit of a gap down in here that's behind this and leaves this unsupported. So I'm going to fill that with construction adhesive and see if that won't support that and keep it from coming off at the same time. This, you could use epoxy for this, but construction adhesive is a water cleanup. It should be a little easier to clean up the mess I'm making. When I get done and let that sit overnight or for a day or so and let that construction adhesive get good and hard,